Today, I'll be programming a Connect4 AI in Python. I'll provide a high-level explanation of all the implementations, but this is not a coding tutorial. You're welcome to look at the well-commented code in the video description on your own. To start, if you're unfamiliar, Connect4 is a two-player game where players take turns dropping a piece of their color into the board. The first player to connect four pieces of their color, like so, wins the game. I started this project by implementing Connect4 logic in Python. This includes methods for making a move, getting a list of legal moves, and determining whether a game is over. The game is represented using a two-dimensional Python list, like so. Technically, it uses 0, 1s, and 2s under the hood, but this is a nicer visual representation. Once we make the Connect4 AI, we will use it to play against real people online, so I felt no need to program a nice visual for this game, since we'll be relying on Connect4 websites instead. The first algorithm I'll try is Minimax. Minimax searches the entire game tree, or all possible states in the game, resulting in optimal play at any given point. The problem is, depending on how many different positions there are, this search could take forever. Specifically, according to this math stack exchange thread, there are 4.5 trillion possible Connect4 situations. Just a note, when I say that Minimax plays optimally, I don't mean that Minimax can't lose. According to Wikipedia, under optimal play, the player to go first always wins in Connect4. Going first is an advantage. So, Minimax would always win when going first, and win when going second only when the opponent plays suboptimally. I wasn't feeling hopeful due to the large number of states, but I implemented Minimax anyways. This is the first website where we will test our code. I use a few Python libraries to find the grid on the screen, read the text at the bottom to figure out whose turn it is, and read pixel values in the middle of each square to figure out which moves the opponent is making. Now let's try out Minimax. Oh no, in the initial stages the best moves are towards the middle. The reason Minimax is placing everything on the left is because it cannot search the game tree deep enough to see that going in the center is more advantageous. Of course, I could think of a good heuristic, but given a few seconds to run, Minimax can only search up to a depth of 5. My implementation might not be the fastest, but the depth of the game tree is 42, so there's no way we can search the whole tree in any reasonable amount of time, even if I optimize my code. Also, it is important to note that Python, as a language, is slower compared to lower level languages like C++. This article, for example, shows that for a certain algorithm, Python is about 25 times slower, so that is another obstacle to our Minimax algorithm. Instead, we will use MCTS, or Monte Carlo Tree Search. To see how good a move is, Monte Carlo Tree Search makes that move and then randomly simulates the game after it to determine whether that move is good. Given enough time, MCTS converges to Minimax, but even if it doesn't have enough time to converge, it will still play pretty well. Suppose we're the blue player in this situation. We're deciding between these three moves. In Monte Carlo Tree Search, we would make the move and then simulate a bunch of random playouts of this game from that position. It's a bit more complex because the game tree is slowly being built up here, but I'm providing a simplified explanation. Let's pretend we do 100 simulations for each of these moves. Suppose for the first move we win 52% of the time, 55% for the second central move, and 44% for the third. As a result, we will choose the middle move because it proved to be more successful when we did the simulations. Let's program this algorithm and play a real human. I'm giving the algorithm 2 seconds per move. Well, this person messed up and then just gave up. Let's do another more interesting match. Here we go second, which is a disadvantage. The program is holding its own for sure, blocking the opponent's attempts to connect four while creating multiple lines of three connected pieces to use in the future. And we end up winning. So is our algorithm perfect and we're done? No, not by a long shot. If we give this code 5 seconds per move, the Monte Carlo tree search algorithm will do about 4,000 to 5,000 iterations per move. This is a good amount, clearly it works pretty well, as you just saw, but if we speed up our Connect 4 implementation, we can get this number up and have better performance overall. This article, written by a data scientist, shows how to present a Connect 4 board using just two numbers: a mask, representing all the pieces on the board, and a position, representing the pieces of one player. Applying the XOR operation between these gives us the position of the other player. What's great about this is that checking whether the game is over is much simpler and faster using bitwise operations between the two numbers. This implementation of Connect 4 is faster than my current 2D Python list implementation. Copying the list from position to position and checking whether 4 are connected is taking up a lot of time, and that time could be used for more iterations of Monte Carlo tree search. So I rewrote the Connect 4 code using this bit board technique, also updating the method that generates legal moves to using the new variables. The result? Well, now in 5 seconds we can do 12 to 13,000 iterations, which is more than double the original implementation. How significant is this difference? Well, I have the two versions play 20 games against each other. The faster version won 14 of them. It won all games where it went first, because it has an advantage, and 40% of those where it went second. This is a definite improvement. But I wasn't done. I made a third version. Here's a Berkeley article about Minimax and game trees. In Monte Carlo tree search, we go from the root of the game tree to some node, and then we do one simulation. Then we go from the root to another node, and then do another simulation. Going from the root to a node takes some time. So I thought, while we're already at a node, let me just run 10 simulations instead of just one. With this technique, our algorithm does more simulations by not having to traverse the tree as often. I wasn't sure whether this will work because this can prevent the Monte Carlo algorithm from exploring other paths, but the facts speak for themselves. Out of 20 games against version 2, version 3 had 14 wins and 2 draws. Outstanding. Now with this buff Monte Carlo tree search agent, I head to a new website. It's time for battle. Paper Games has a Connect 4 ranking that's updated every day. I'll just run a few games right now to show you how it works, and then try to crack the top 10 tomorrow once a new tournament starts. Here, I use a similar technique of looking at each grid's circle's pixel values to figure out what the opponent is doing. And just like that, we force a win. Today is the new day. I ran this bot for a few hours, and as you can see, we are in the top 10. The Connect 4 AI forces another win here, pushing us to 9th place. Our record consists of 46 wins and 19 defeats, some of which are against other bots. That's over a 70% win rate, which is pretty solid. I won't go for first place because most of the top 10 is occupied by bots, many of which are written in a faster programming language. I know this because no human is bored enough to play this for 9 hours a day like these people right here. I had my bot play for 2 hours and we barely cracked the top 10. Looking at the top player, we see some unreal statistics. Their bot is definitely running the full version of Minimax in another programming language. If there's enough interest, I'll make a follow-up video where I implement Minimax in C++, and see how much of an improvement we can make over the current algorithm we have, which is already pretty solid and hard to beat for a human. If you enjoyed this video, I appreciate a like and subscribe. Everything I discussed today can be learned more about in the video description. Thanks for watching!